But, you know, it won't be pretty. American carnage. It sounds like a wrestling tournament. And as it turns out, it has been a clusterfuck from day one, when Trump just suddenly decided his was the most attended inauguration in history, even though it wasn't. That particular lie was a statement of intent. And the statement was, we are going to lie to you. We are going to lie to your face and punish anyone who calls it a lie. The statement was, the truth no longer matters. Reality is negotiable. Through blatant manipulation and outright lies, you are about to witness the deliberate degradation of Western democracy. Because democracy can't work when you can't distinguish true from false. His presidency started with the first of many lies. His presidency ended with a mob smashing up Congress because they'd been lied to and believed the election was stolen from them. Where do you think they got that idea? That particular lie began before he'd even taken office, baselessly claiming he'd won the popular vote because millions of Hillary's votes were fraudulent, making him the first president in history to moan about an election that he'd already fucking won. American carnage, and that's what they got as they were clearing up the blood and taking the dead bodies out of the Capitol building. It still took him 2 days to condemn the violence, and only because there was serious talk of evoking the 25th. He fucking loved it, just the way he likes it, fanning the flames of hate and division. He spent 4 years calling black guys taking a knee at a ball game anti-American sons of bitches. 6 months ago, he happily tear gassed peaceful protesters so he could get a photo op. But when protesters storm Congress, replace the American flag with a MAGA one, take a shit on the Senate floor, and beat a police officer to death, we love you, special people, true patriots, running around Congress, waving Confederate flags, brandishing baseball bats. What could be more American? You remember when we were all in shock that Trump won the White House and they were like, yeah, get over it, snowflakes, we won fair and square. Now fucking look at them. Who are the fucking snowflakes now? He refuses to chastise anyone who supports him, no matter how fucking mad or criminal they are, because his ego is as big as his penis is small. Last week, Trump finally said that no true supporter of his would ever resort to violence. Difficult to swallow, seeing as most of them were waving flags with your fucking name on them, covered head to toe in MAGA merchandise. Is it great again yet? Is it? I remember before he won, he promised, we'll have so much winning if I get elected that you'll get bored of winning. And yet, he leaves office as the country's biggest loser in history. He's lost the House, the Senate, the popular vote, twice, and the White House. He lost a million Americans their health insurance, as well as 400,000 American lives because of his willful indifference to COVID-19. Sorry, Kung Flu, as he hilariously puts it. And because of his attacks on democracy, he's lost the respect of the entire planet. You now have places like Iran lecturing America about the evils of populism. High fives all across the Kremlin. Mission accomplished. That was Scottish. Beijing, for the first time ever, allowing an insurrection to actually be broadcast on its TV screens. He's lost America the right to do what America does best. Lecture the rest of the world about democracy. The only thing he's achieved is lowering his golf handicap and putting a couple of religious zealots and a rapist on the Supreme Court bench. To his credit, he did bring troops home from Afghanistan, Iraq, and Syria, but most of them are now in mortal danger protecting the Capitol from his supporters. It's now clear that his stolen election myth is there to hide his weakness, hide the fact that he is a loser with an ego so fragile he'd rather undermine democracy than admit to his most rabid supporters that he lost. And you know why we know beyond any doubt that he lost? Because of the unprecedented number of court rulings, safety checks, and recounts that Trump's lies gave rise to. The 60 legal challenges laughed out of court meant Trump's own election security team declared the election the most secure in America's history. Even Bill Barr conceded there was no significant fraud. If he'd kept his mouth shut, Joe Biden would have won this presidency only once, but thanks to Trump, Biden's win has been reconfirmed almost daily for the last 10 weeks. If he'd have gone quietly, his grip on the Republican Party was assured. Let's not forget, Trump won more votes than any Republican in history. If he'd have been smart, he'd have been the presumptive nominee next time. But he's not smart. He can barely string a fucking sentence together, other than, I'm the best. In an attempt to save himself and his wafer-thin ego, he ended up sabotaging himself and his party, who are now reaping the rewards for having enabled him for so long. How do they recover from Trump? As one commentator put it, Trump wore the Republican Party like a rented tuxedo, and now they face the dry cleaning bill. He leaves behind a party whose base now consists of conspiracy theorists dressed up as Beowulf. The party that ended slavery now goes to great lengths to suppress the black vote. The party of traditional family values now pays off porn stars. The pro-globalization party has a protectionist president. The Second Amendment party has seen its spiritual sibling, the NRA, go from all-powerful to bankrupt. The pro-life party, thanks to Trump, doesn't believe in wearing masks to protect the lives of its fellow citizens. The party of law and order, fuck me. The law says, you fucking lost the election, mate. The law says, don't incite people to break into the Capitol in an attempt to hang the vice president. Law and order? This president has taken a liquid shit over both of those concepts. The party of fiscal responsibility just added $9 trillion to the national debt, and yet Donald Trump is so deluded he believes he's the greatest American president since Lincoln. But the truth is, he'll be remembered as the worst president in modern history. A man with so little reverence for the seat of office he was elected to, he's willing to sell presidential pardons for a cool $2 million ago. A man with so little respect for his devout followers that he's willing to ask them to donate to his Stop the Steal campaign so he can pay off his debts. A man feeling so castrated since his resounding loss that he's demonstrated his power by sending as many people to the electric chair as he can before leaving office. Donald Trump. The unpresidential president, loud, brash, like a pantomime dame without the dress or the makeup, without the dress. Anyway, I mean, what sort of shit white supremacist makes himself look like a tangerine, a lame duck a l'orange president, a fucking lunatic who wishes child rapists well, the people's president who gives billions to the top 1%, a sociopathic, ill-informed, self-righteous, subliterate, gurning, dog-whistling, know-nothing xenophobe for whom all Mexicans are rapists, all Muslims are terrorists, struggling third world nations are shithole countries, and where white supremacists and proud boys are fine and special people, an ignorant, amoral, war hero mocking petulant authoritarian who showers praise on murderous dictators while undermining America's allies. A heartless, paper towel throwing demagogue. A kafifi inventing, tax return withholding, flatulent pig. A president who takes no responsibility, for whom the buck stops somewhere over there. A president who quotes Mussolini, who openly wants to fuck his own daughter. A vicious, reactionary scumbag. Putin fellating, spiteful charlatan, a gluttonous, lobotomized, mushroom-dicked sexual predator parading his dangerous ignorance as if it's a virtue, a disgusting, morally bankrupt bully, a supremely entitled, tasteless, talentless, draft-dodging, gaslighting misogynist who locks kids up in cages, a bleach-injecting super-spreader who abolished the pandemic preparedness response team because it had Obama's name on it, resulting in 4,000 deaths a day, an economy in tatters, job numbers down the Swanee. Is it great again yet? I could go on, but, you know, like I say, it's Biden's special day. So, I mean, should we just go with divisive? Leave it at that. It's working. It's working. Okay. Are we happy to go for a rehearsal? It's Inauguration Day. This time 4 years ago, Donald Trump was about to become the 45th President of the United States of America. But today, it is the turn of Joseph R. Biden Jr.